Hello everyone, welcome to the seminar on NACO Prayogshala, an online portal for electronic data entry of proficiency testing and reverse testing. As we all know, under external quality assessment program, proficiency testing and reverse testing is conducted among the NACP laboratories, and the results and the reports are being submitted by hard copies. NACO, in collaboration with NARI Pune and Share India, has developed an online data management tool, NACOPrayogshala.in, to facilitate the electronic data entry and reporting by the respective laboratories. This tool can be accessed by the URL www.nacoprayogshala.in. This tool is compatible for access through all electronic devices such as computer, laptop, as well as mobile. And if tab is there, tab can also be used. Now we will see how to operate this tool for data entry as well as the review of the results. To open this tool, we need to type the address of this tool, which is nacoprayogshala.in, in the address bar of the browser. Browser can be anything, whether it is Internet Explorer, Google Chrome. This tool is compatible for all the browsers. So in the browsers, we need to type the address of this tool, web address of this tool. So I will type in the web address www.nacoprayogshala.in. Once I type this, I will click on this. So in the home page, you will see tool for ICTC QMS and tool for SPT and RT, that is proficiency testing and reverse testing. We are interested here in proficiency testing and reverse testing. Therefore, I will click on the icon tool for PT and RT. Once I will click on the tool for PT and RT, another page which is specific for the reverse testing and proficiency testing data management system will open. So now here you can see, to access this tool, you will require login ID and a password. So how I will get this login ID and password? So this will be obtained by registering by the facility. Facility here is whether it is ICTC, SRL, NRL or Apex laboratories. So here in the reverse testing and proficiency testings, ICTC, SRL, NRL and Apex laboratories are involved. So everybody need to register in this portal. So if I am an ICTC, I will register as an ICTC, then I will click on the tab ICTC. Once I will click on this tab ICTC, it will open a registration page. So you can see here several options are there for the registration. This registration is a one-time activity. Here we need to register first to obtain a user ID and password. How it will process, we will see here. Now the type of facilities, already we have clicked on the ICTC, therefore type of the facility is an ICTC. Further, we need to type the name of the facility. My ICTC is ICTC Rural Hospital, Singapore. Next field is a SIMS ID. So every ICTC is provided with the SIMS ID, which is used for the access of the SIMS software. So that SIMS ID you need to type in this field. Why this SIMS ID is required? Which is because the SIMS ID is unique ID for each ICTC. So if my SIMS ID is one zero one zero one zero one, you can see here, as I type my SIMS ID in row number 3, the same SIMS ID will appear on the row number 15, which is a user ID. So in all, your SIMS ID will be your user ID. there is no need to type that SIEMS ID again in the user ID. It will be automatically fetched up in the row number 15. Now, national identification number is the next field. If the ICTC is allotted with the national identification number, they can type here. If not, then they can leave this column blank. So if for my ICTC, say for I am a representative for this ICTC, I am a lab technician of this ICTC, I don't have national identification number, so I will not type. I will keep this row blank. Next is name of the link reporting laboratory. So here, what is link reporting laboratory? As I said, I am an ICTC. I am a laboratory technician of an ICTC rural hospital, Shikrapur. Then my link reporting laboratory is my SRL. So if my SRL is BJMC Pune, BJ Medical College Pune, so I will select my appropriate SRL, state reference laboratory. If I am an SRL, then my link reporting laboratory will be NRL. If I am an NRL, then my reporting laboratory is Apex Laboratory. So accordingly, you have to select your link reporting laboratory. As I said, this is a one-time activity. One should be very careful in selecting the link reporting laboratory, because if you are not selected a correct laboratory, then you will not receive the report, right? Next field is official email ID. My official email ID, suppose abc@gmail.com. Whatever my email address is there, I will type that official email address. Don't type personal email address. It should be an official email address of that ICTC, right? Next column is complete name of the institution. So sometimes the name of the ICTC and a complete name of the ICTC may be different. So that time you have to select the appropriate complete name of the institution, that is ICTC. So my complete name of ICTC. It's the same as my name of the ICTC. The next is a postal address. Postal address is opposite. Railway station. Right. Now, next is a state. You have a drop-down menu from where you can select your appropriate state. So for this ICTC, the state is Maharashtra. So I will select Maharashtra. Next column is a district. So you have to type your district and then pin code. So this is my pin code. Now next row is row number 12, which is the name of contact person in the facility. Here, in ICTC, the reverse testing and proficiency testing is mainly handled by the laboratory technician. So contact person is a laboratory technician, which is more appropriate. So every ICTC should write a name of the laboratory technician. In fact, the registration should be done by the laboratory technician. Now, if a name of the laboratory technician is, I will say XYZ. So here you can see here in the bracket, you will see a NACO staff. So preferably a NACO staff, NACO appointed laboratory technician should be a preferable person to register and to handle this too. If the post is vacant and somebody else is handling the reverse testing and proficiency testing, that time the name of that laboratory technician can be typed here. A mobile number of a contact person, say for my mobile number is this. Alternate landline number can be a landline number of a hospital or a medical college. In the next column, it is column number 15, which is user ID. And user ID, it is automatically fetched up from the SIMS ID. So no need to type or edit, and it is not permitted also in this tool. Now, next column is a preferred password for the login. So here, one can choose your preferred password for the further login. So my password, I have typed my password. Confirm the password by typing it again. Now I have filled all the necessary fields in this registration sheet. You can see here, there are asterisks or a star in some of the fields. Here, 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 here. What does it mean? So asterisks means these are the mandatory fields. So if you left these fields unfilled, then registration will not complete. The system will not allow to proceed further. So one should ensure that all the fields which are labeled with the asterisks are filled. Now I will recheck my information before submitting the information. So now everything I have filled correctly. One more thing one should do is just write down the user ID and a password in one page, because during the pilot run we have observed that people have registered and they forgot either user ID or password, and so many queries were received. So I will suggest write down a user ID and a password on a paper, keep it in a sealed envelope and place it at secure place, whether it is with the counselor or a medical officer or in a cupboard of the ICTC. Whenever it is required, that time that sealed envelope can be opened. So it may happen that one may forgot the user ID or password. That time it will be a handy tool to remember the user ID and password. So I have filled all the fields and I have verified the information, which is correct. And I have recorded the user ID and password on a paper and I have kept it in a sealed envelope. Now, the next step is to submit the data for the registration, for completion of the registration. You can see here, a submit tab, reset tab, and a home button is there. When I click on the submit button, the data will get submitted and user ID and password is created for this ICTC. If I click on the reset button, the information that are typed in the fields will get away. So everything will be blank. And if I click on the home button, it will return to the home page of this tool. So now I want to register my ICTC, then therefore I will click on the submit button. So once I submit the registration information, the successful registration page will open. Registration completed successfully will be appear on the screen, and then I will click on the home button. So I will go to the home page of this tool. Now as an ICTC, I have a user ID and password. Therefore I can type login ID and password and use this reverse testing and proficiency testing data management tool. Likewise, SRL and NRL need to register first. This is one time activity. This tool was piloted in some of the area where ICTC have registered and entered the reverse testing and proficiency testing data. So for those ICTC, there is no need to re-register. They can use their registered user ID and password, login ID and password for continuing the uses of this tool. For those ICTCs or SRL or NRL who have yet not registered, they need to register first. So now, as an example, we have just registered as an ICTC Rural Hospital Shikrapur Pune, and we got a login ID and password as a process of registration, after the process of registration. So now, for the further use of reverse testing and proficiency testing data management tool, I will type login ID, which was obtained by the registration process, in the login ID field. Then I also have a password. So I will type password and then I will click on the login button. Once I click on the login button, next page or a login page of the reverse testing and proficiency testing data management tool is open. So now I have logged in as an ICTC, a particular ICTC. So my profile is appeared here. A type of facility ICTC, which is correct. I have registered as an ICTC. My name of the facility is ICTC Rural Hospital Shikrapur Pune. That was also correct. And SIMS ID is 1010101. That was typed during the registration. So just ensure that you have typed the correct user ID and password. You should check this profile data. Once it is correct, then you will have several options below. So here we are interested in online data entry of reverse testing and proficiency testing, as well as to view the report. The options for data entry as well as the report, viewing the report, is given here. You can see here reverse testing and proficiency testing, both things are there. For the reverse testing, a tab for entering data and tab for view report. View report is given. As well as for the proficiency testing, tab for entering data and viewing report is given. So now I want to enter the data for reverse testing. I have submitted the samples to the my higher tier laboratory, which is SRLs, and I want to enter the data. To do that, I will click on the enter data. Once I click on the enter data, a new page for entering the reverse testing data will open. Now you can see here row number 1 to row number 6 are already filled. This data is fetched up from the data which was entered during the registration. So no need to re-enter this data. Is already there. Every time you enter, click on the enter data, this data will be there. Now we will enter the data for the reverse testing. So we will start from the row number 7, which is reporting for the month. So if I am reporting for the month of July, so I will click on the select the appropriate month, and then next is financial year. So now we are in financial year 1920. So July 1920, I will select the financial year 1920. Next column is date of QMS certification. As you know, NACO has undertaken a program for quality management system implementation, and NACO certified the few ICTCs who have successfully implemented the quality management system, and the ICTCs audited by the external agency. So if the ICTC is already certified for the quality management system implementation by NACO, then that date can be entered here. If ICTC is not yet certified, then they can leave this row blank. So this ICTC, suppose this ICTC is not certified with the quality management system, I will leave it blank. Then I will move to the next row, which is row number 9. Name of the first kit used at ICTC. So ICTC is using 3 kits. As per the strategy 3, they are using 3 different rapid kits for testing the samples for HIV antibody testing. So which first kits ICTC is using, they need to type in this column. So my first test is COMBETS rapid test. My second test is Mary Screen rapid test, and my third test is Signal rapid test. So these 3 kits are being used in my ICTC, therefore I am typing this information. Next is a section number second. This is section number first. See here, section number first and section number second, which is a general data filled by ICTC. So here in general data, number of HIV tests done in the previous quarter. What is mean by previous quarter? I am entering the reverse testing data for the July. That means I have to submit the reverse testing samples 4 times a year, and I am typing for the month of July. So my previous quarter will be April, May, June. If I am entering the data for the month of April, then my previous quarter will be January, February, March. So there are 4 quarters: January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. So if you are entering the data for the reporting month July, then previous 3 months will be your previous quarter. So total number of HIV tests done in the previous quarter should be entered here. Say for 500 tests done in the previous quarter, then how many HIV positive cases in the previous quarter? Say for 10 positive cases, HIV 1 positive cases were there, and 1 HIV 2. Then next is number of HIV 2 positive cases, that will be 1. Number of samples screened as HIV 1 plus 2 positive in the previous quarter. Here you can see number of HIV 1 plus 2 positive reports issued to the patient. So if you know that the patient is confirmed HIV 1 plus 2, then that number you should give here. If the patient is referred for the confirmation of the HIV 2 to the confirm HIV 2 confirmation repository, then one should get the true status, then only report here. So if I know that I have referred one patient which was HIV 1 plus 2 to the HIV 2 confirmatory laboratory, and they also confirm that the patient status is HIV 1 plus 2, then I will write here that I got one HIV 1 plus 2 positive sample in this quarter. If it is not, then you can type 0. Important here is, if you don't have any HIV 2 positive or HIV 1 positive or HIV 1 plus 2 positive, then you should type 0. Don't keep a field blank. Next column is fifth, number of sample screen as indeterminate in previous quarter. So if I got one indeterminate sample and I sent that sample to the SRL, then I will type as 1. Next column is number of LTs working in the ICTC. If one LT is appointed by the SACS or NACO, then I will type 1. If two LTs are appointed, then I will type 2. Consider in this ICTC, two LTs are working in the ICTC, two LTs are appointed. Next column is row number 7, LT supported by. So here, what is meant by LT supported by? Two options are there, NACO and institution. If both the LTs are appointed by the NACO, that means both the LTs are NACO staff, then we will select NACO. If both the LTs are institutional LTs and NACO posts are vacant, therefore the institutional LTs are delegated the responsibility for this ICTC rapid test, then I will select institution. So next section is section number 3, reverse QC testing field by ICTC. So first row is RCA CA done for discordant sample in previous quarter. So now we are entering the data for the month July. So here we have to enter the data for the previous quarter, that is the month of April. What is meant by RCA and CA? RCA is a root cause analysis and CA is a corrective action. So if in the previous reverse testing samples submitted to the SRL, if I get any discordant result, then ICTC should take a root cause analysis and corrective action for the discordant obtained by the SRL. If that is completed, then they should select yes. If it is not, they should select no. If there is no discordant, then they should select not applicable, right? Next row is sample submission date in current quarter. Now, for the July month, I have submitted the sample on A, then I will select 22 July. Next column is number of HIV positive samples sent to SRL in this quarter. So at that time, I have sent 2 positive samples, and next is number of negative samples sent to SRL in this quarter are say for 10. So I have sent 2 positive samples and 10 negative samples. If there is any other remark, they can type here in the remark column. Now just check whether all the fields that are filled in this tool are correct or not. If everything is correct, then click on the submit button. So I will click on the submit button. As I have checked everything is filled and is correct. Home page will appear. Data is submitted successfully. So I will click on the home tab and I will return to the home page of this tool. So here we have entered the reverse testing data. Now what is mean by this VIV report? VIV report means we have entered the data. Now SRL will review the data. The samples that are dispatched to the SRL, they will test and they will upload the result of that samples. They will enter the results. So, and the report that is generated by the SRLs can be viewed by the ICTC by clicking the View Report tab. When I click on the View Report, I will get my report sheet. So here, my SIMS ID is correct. Then I will select the month. I want to see the report of the month July for the financial year 19-20, and I will click on the search. So when I click on the search, I will get data in the below table. Here you can see here name of my ICTC, SIMS code, month, year, when I have submitted the data or samples. I have submitted the samples on this date, and I have submitted the data on this date. So everything is written here. The date reviewed by the SRL column is blank because just now we have submitted the data and SRL has yet not reviewed the data. So if it is blank, that means SRL has not uploaded the data or a report. Suppose if SRL has reviewed the data and uploaded the report, the date and time will appear here. So we will come to this later when SRL will upload the data to view the report. Now I will click on the home page. I will go to the my home page of the reverse testing and proficiency testing data tool. Now I have uploaded the data for the reverse testing. The next is proficiency testing. If I want to upload the data for the proficiency testing, I will click on the tab Enter Data. Once I click on the Enter Data, a proficiency testing data page will open. As you can see here, there are two sections, section 1 and section 2. In section 1, 1 to 6 rows are autofilled, which are fetched up from the registration data. Row number 7 is round for the proficiency testing. So as you all know, proficiency testing is conducted twice a year. So there are two rounds, first round and second round. So if I am entering the data for the first round, then I will select first. So SRL has submitted the samples to me, that is ICTC, and I have tested the samples and I got the results. So I will enter the data in this tool. So the round is first and for the financial year 19-20. Now come to the section number 2, which is proficiency testing samples. Again, here it is first row is RCA and CA, that is root cause analysis and corrective action done for the discordant samples for the last round. So last round means last proficiency testing round in which ICTC participated in proficiency testing and received the results. So here my last round will be previous to this. So in 1920 first round, my previous round will be 1820 second round, right? So if I got the discordant results in the proficiency testing samples, then I am bound to take the root cause analysis and corrective action. Then it is necessary to take root cause analysis and corrective action by the ICTC. If it is complete, then select yes. If root cause analysis or corrective action is not completed, then select no. If there was no discordance in the last round, the proficiency testing samples pass the round, then select not applicable. Next row is sample receive date for the reporting round. So our reporting round is round first of the financial year 1920. So on which date samples are received from the SRLs, that date need to be entered. And I have tested on the 10th September. So I will write the date accordingly. Now for an ICTC, 4-member panel is received from the SRL. And SRL test the samples and generate the results. So for the member 1, member 2, member 3, member 4, accordingly the results need to be selected from the respective drop-down menus. So I have entered the sample received date and sample tested date. Now next is to enter the results of the panel. 4-member panel is being received by the ICTC from the SRLs. SRL test the samples and generate the results. So for each member, select the appropriate results from the drop-down menu and enter the results. So for this ICTC, member 1 is tested as positive, so I have selected positive. Member 2 is tested as a negative, then select negative. Member 3 is tested as positive, then I have selected positive. Member 4 is tested as negative, so I have selected negative. Now next is remark. If there is any remark, then just enter the remark. If there is no remarks, just type none, right? Recheck the data entered in this page, and if it is okay, then click on the submit button. Once you submit the button, a data submitted successfully page will open. Just click on the home, you will return on the home page of the data tool. So now you have entered the data for the reverse testing, you have entered the data for the proficiency testing. The BEAV report we have already seen for the reverse testing BEAV report. For the proficiency testing, when you click on the BEAV report, a report page will open for the proficiency testing. Select the round for which you want to see the result. Select the year appropriate and search. Click on the search. So here again, as reverse testing, as we have seen in the reverse testing BEAV report, the same data will be appeared. Here you can see the data reviewed by SRL column is blank. That means ICTC has submitted the results, but SRL has not reviewed the report. That's why this column is blank. Once SRL reviewed the report and upload the report, the date and time of uploading the report will be appear. We will see how this will be viewed. So now we will view the report. So for the reverse testing, we will to check the report of the reverse testing samples that were submitted to the SRLs. Click on the view report. Report page of the reverse testing results will appear. Select the month for which you want to view the report. Select the appropriate year and then click on the search. Once you click on the search, details will appear in the below table. Here, name of the ICTC, SIMS codes, month and year for which you are searching for the results. The date when samples were submitted and date when data were uploaded by the ICTC is appears. And the last column is data reviewed by the SRL. So here you can see that on 13th September, at on 11:49 a.m., the data was reviewed by the SRL. So report is available. If report is not available or uploaded by the SRLs, then this column will get blank. Okay. Now it is filled with the date and time. That means on this date and on this time, data was uploaded by the SRL. report is uploaded by the SRM. So now to view the reports, you can see here everything, the SIM score is underlined. All other fields are not underlined, only SIM score is underlined. And when you move your cursor on the SIM score, your cursor shape changes. So you have to click on the SIM score. Once you click on the SIM score, you will get the report. So here, your data which was entered during the data entry appears here, which is not editable. You cannot edit that because it was already submitted. And you can also see the fields which are orange in color are the data submitted by the SRL. So here, first thing is, you have entered that during the last reporting quarter, you got the one indeterminate samples, which was sent to the SRLs. Here, the SRL has reported that the indeterminate case resolved at the SRLs in the quarter and report is submitted to the ICTC, right? ICTC has submitted the samples, which was tested at the SRL on this date. And the results of that samples were satisfactory. That means the results of all the samples match with the SRL results. That's why it is called satisfactory. If it is unsatisfactory, then details of unsatisfactory samples will be given here. If positive samples found discordant, then number of positive samples will be here and the details of that mismatch will be typed here, appear here. If negative samples found discordant, then details of the negative samples will get appear here. If any remark given by the SRLs, that will be appear in the row number 5. Right? So likewise, you can view your report of the retest reverse testing data that was submitted by to the SRL. SRL can print the report by click on the print tab, right? I'm not printing right now. So I will go to the home page. Now, I have viewed the report for the reverse testing. I want to view the report for the proficiency testing submitted to the SRL. So I will click on the view report. A report page of the proficiency testing will open. I will select the round for which I want to see the report. Select the year for which I want to see the result and click on the search. Again, you can see here data reviewed by SRL column is filled. That means report is uploaded by the SRL on this date and this time. So to view the report, I will click on the SIMS ID. A report page of the proficiency testing will open. The data submitted by the ICTC to the SRL will appear. You can also see the orange rows. The orange rows are the data uploaded by the SRLs. So this is the 4-member panel for which ICTC has submitted the results. And for that, SRL has submitted their results, whether the results were concordant for particular member or not. So for this ICTC, the results for the member 1 is concordant, member 2 is concordant, member 3 is concordant, member 4 is concordant, right? And final proficiency testing result is satisfactory. SRL can print the report by clicking on the print icon. So likewise, SRL will submit the report and ICTC can view and print the report. So now this electronic data entry and reporting system will be functional to all the ICTCs. As we have discussed earlier, at present, a manual data submission by hard copies and reporting of the report by hard copies is going on. Till further instructions, the submission of the results and the reports by hard copies will go on as it is. Simultaneously, this electronic data entry and reporting will also go until further notice from the NACO. Right. So now I have entered the data for the reverse testing. I have waived the report. I have printed the report. Similarly, for the proficiency testing, I have entered the data. I have waived the report. Now, once you finish the work, you should log out. Do not leave or do not close by crossing the close button. Just log out from your tool after finishing your work. You will be directed into the main page of the reverse testing and proficiency testing data management tool. This is how you can enter the data and view the report for the reverse testing and proficiency testing. Thank you very much.